Hi, my name is Stéphane Pommier, and together with you, I want to explore radioactivity. Radioactive decay is a spontaneous stochastic process whereby an unstable nucleus transforms into another nucleus. Different types of ionizing radiation can be emitted, such as helium nuclei called alpha particles, high-energy photons called gamma rays, and electrons or positrons called beta particles. Radioactivity is omnipresent in nature. In soil, we find, for example, uranium-238, which decays to a series of other unstable nuclides. This decay chain stops when stable lead is reached. Each radionuclide has its own half-life, by which half of the atoms are expected to decay. Unlike with an hourglass, it is not so that all atoms are decayed after two half-lives. The number of surviving atoms follows an exponential curve. Radioactivity is used as a clock in geochronology. We know that Earth is 4.5 billion years old because all short-lived nuclides have decayed away, and only nuclides with long half-lives have survived with time. On the chart of nuclides, we can see the different types of radioactive decay. The black dots represent the valley of stability. In the purple region, nuclides are in excess of protons and decay by beta plus emission or electron capture to reduce the proton number. In orange are the nuclides with too many neutrons. They can convert a neutron into a proton by beta minus decay. The heavy nuclides in yellow and green can go on a nuclear diet by emitting a heavy alpha particle, or take a crash diet by splitting into two fragments. Beta minus decay is the only spontaneous process in which a nucleus can cure from neutron excess by transforming a neutron into a proton and emitting an electron and antineutrino from inside the nucleus. The mass number stays the same, so it is an isobaric process. The antineutrino cannot be detected, but we know that it takes away, on average, 2/3 of the released energy, leaving the beta particle with the remaining fraction, which can be any value between 0 and the Q value. In an energy diagram, we start from an unstable nucleus with a high energy, jump to a lower energy state in the daughter product, and possibly go further down by gamma transitions. Whereas the excitation energy is usually expelled through emission of gamma rays, sometimes the energy is converted to kick out an orbital electron, which is then called a conversion electron. Most excited levels in a nucleus are short-lived, but some live long enough to be called metastable states, and their decay is called isomeric transition. Beta plus decay is somewhat opposite to beta minus decay. It converts a proton into a neutron with emission of a positron and a neutrino. The positron is the antimatter counterpart of an electron and has a positive charge. There's also a difference with respect to the energy diagram. Beta plus decay requires 1 MeV for the creation of an electron-positron pair in the nucleus, so that less energy is available to the positron and neutrino. This is what happens with the emitted positron. It meets an electron, and together they annihilate, and matter is converted into pure energy in the shape of two 511 keV photons, which fly away in opposite directions. Nuclear fireworks, which has a nice application in PET scanners for medical imaging. Beta plus decay has a competitor, namely electron capture decay. The nucleus steals away an electron from one of the inner atomic shells and then converts a proton into a neutron and emits a neutrino. After electron capture, the atom has some rearranging to do. If a K-shell electron has been captured, an electron of a higher shell will take its place, and an X-ray is emitted, or an Auger electron. This results in one or two gaps in higher shells, which in turn have to be filled. Notice how atoms and nuclei de-excite in similar ways. When electrons rearrange in atoms, the kV excitation energy is taken away by X-rays or Auger electrons. When nucleons rearrange, gamma rays in the MeV range are emitted, or conversion electrons. Alpha decay is a sport played by the heavyweight class of nuclides. Excessive mass is lost by emission of a helium nucleus with a kinetic energy of 4 to 8 MeV. In classical physics, an alpha particle cannot escape from the nucleus because of the Coulomb barrier. In quantum mechanics, it is possible to tunnel through the barrier. Even heavier particle clusters can escape, but that happens very rarely. Then, what to think of spontaneous fission of a nucleus? This was believed energetically impossible at its discovery. But later, it was realized that a potential barrier could be overcome if a big nucleus would stretch like a water drop into a dumbbell shape and then break apart. In reactors, fission is induced by neutrons, which give the nucleus that extra binding energy it needs to pass the barrier. And with this bombshell, we have reached the end of this decadent course. Thank you for your attention, and don't lose your excitement.